How does it feel to be here and bringing this film to this festival?
Oh, it's wonderful because, you know, I lived for 8 months in Cambridge in 2007, and I used to come here in London and to the Odeon Theatre and Empire Theatre, and being here with a movie tonight is like a dream come true, you know, it's wonderful. It's my first film that was shown in the UK, so here I am.
Very exciting times. Tell us a little bit about the character that you play in this film.
Oh yeah, I play Simone, which is a very normal guy who, you know, studying at university, hangs out with two friends of his. And one day they decide to break into a house of a very wealthy man, and accidentally, at a certain point, he goes into the basement of the house and he discovers something he should have never discovered, you know? And bad things happen after it. I guess the difficult part of this movie was the torture scene, you know? I had to prepare a lot about on that. Actually, that scene, the torture scene, was also the scene I had to do for the audition. And I had to audition like 5 or 6 times before I could get the role. So I worked a lot on, you know, the emotion you have when you are in a crazy situation like that. And yeah, it was very demanding, but I hope I did a nice job. It's wonderful because Marco, he's very... he follows you a lot, he directs you a lot. Antonio is more focused on the camera, all the movements, but then they are just one director. The Manetti Bros, they are one thing. And they are very nice with you, and but also they're very demanding. They want to take the best of you out of you, you know? And one thing I love about them is that they say what they think, for real. Also on set, also in real life, you know, they're very nice people. It's a chance to go to the movies, relax and be scared, you know. It's fun to be scared sometimes.
And have you got any particular favorite horror movies that inspire you?
No, not really, but when I was very young, little, like 6, I watched all the Nightmare on Elm Street films, and I was like very scared, you know, I was like 6. So.
Did that, any of that bear some inspiration for some of your scenes in this film?
No, not really. I tried to...
You didn't imagine Freddy Krueger coming up?
Yeah. I, as an actor, I never try to imitate other actors or... things that happens in films, because I think it's not legit. Can you say that?
Yeah,
legitimate. Yeah, real.
Yeah, absolutely.
Actually, this is my first movie that came out in Italy to be shown mainstream in Italy, all around Italy. And my first film to be shown in the UK. So I heard a lot of times about the Fright Fest. And being here with this movie is just great, you know? It did very well, you know? We received very good critics, and also at cinemas it went well, so we were happy.
Yeah. And what's coming up next for you?
I just shot a movie in Italy near Turin. Should come out like next summer, but it's not a horror film, it's like a very normal film set in a small village.
What's it called?
It's called E fu sera e fu mattina. I have no idea how to translate it in English. Sorry.
And when can we expect that?
Next summer.
Next summer.
I hope it could go out in some festival. I have no idea. I hope.
Well, we look forward to seeing it. One last thing. Do you have a message for all of the fans of Fright Fest and, of course, this film?
Oh, yeah. Please go and see Paura 3D and have fun. And go and see all the other horror films, because this festival is all about horror, you know? We have to enjoy it.